Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. I am delighted to bring Santeep ji with us once again, and we just had a discussion for almost 90 minutes, I guess, on on relationship compatibility. And today Moon is also in Rohini, and Rohini is very well known for relationships and, you know, attraction between people. So I thought, in fact, we decided to speak on some other topic, if I remember right, on nakshatras. But then we are always a puppet of the nakshatras. Whatever nakshatras do, we just end up doing that or what they want us to do. So therefore, today, Santeep ji will speak on compatibility and what happens primarily when different planets come over your chart, when you are staying with somebody. And this is not for some physical, emotional or sexual compatibility. This can be seen, as we discussed, for friends, family members, relatives also. So for example, if you have a sibling with whom you don't get along and you want to see how you can, you know, develop the relationship with the sibling, you know, so that you don't keep fighting always. So then also you can use this information, and for marriage and for your married life, you can always use this information. So Sandeep ji, namaste, welcome to Exotic Astrology once again, and please enlighten us.
Namaskar, namaste Babaji, and all your viewers also. It was interesting, you know, we, as you mentioned, we thought we'll talk about some other topic, and this topic just came as we were talking, so we just decided why not just talk about that. So what we were talking about was actually the synastry, what is known as synastry planets. So synastry, in which you put one chart on top of the other chart and you see how interacting. And we were talking, so say you have a planet and say you have Rahu in Leo. Let's assume that. And you're talking with someone else who has some other planet in Leo. And then you can see that your Rahu, because it's in Leo, is interacting with the other person's planets, which are also in Leo. So other person might have Sun, other person might have Moon. But those corresponding interaction is playing out because you're sharing the same of Leo. So it's like you have Rahu. So imagine Rahu is in one room because of you, and the person Sun and Moon is in the same room because of that person. So that's what is happening, you know. So in that same house, you see it's literally that, you know, that planetary interactions are happening in a very specific manner. So you were just talking about different kind of synastry and what we're seeing and all that, you know. So I'll just start with simple basic stuff with regard to synastry. So of course, the easiest thing I've seen, especially in relationship synastry, it's very important usually. And I've seen synastry working very well in context of marriage, very, very important. So we were just talking about that also. So usually what I've seen, one of the best planets to have on top of that in general, so say your ascendant is in any sign, if the other person's moon is on top of your ascendant, it is very, very good. Okay. Because you can see that moon is always nurturing that ascendant influence. That is one thing. So the other person's karmas are linked with your ascendant, life path and all that. That is always good. But that is a common link. Actually, they say that. But then, of course, that's only really one of the factors. You have to look at all other planetary interactions also. By the time when you look at all the planet interaction, you understand why it played out and what played out exactly. So what I've seen is that the planets on top of the ascendant become very, very important. So if your ascendant is in Gemini, the other person's sun is in Gemini, it's almost as if that person is giving you a lot of energy and direction and power literally to you. And you will feel that this person is becoming very dominating on top of you and things like that. And of course, you have to, that can also be seen. So that's why Moon is supposed to be a much more benign kind of influence, you know, even though Sun is very important. Sun is like a person is kind of pledging you to be individualistic, you at a very soul level, the deep soul level, that Atma kind of connection, very great. Sun kind of connection is very great. Whereas Moon kind of connection is much more emotional kind of connection, is very, very strong. So that other person's emotion is actually supporting you in many, many easier fashion. You know. The other thing with Moon, can also, now this can also play out interestingly in terms of deities also, I've seen. So say you have sun, the other person's sun coming on top of your ascendant. So this person will take you to like Shiva and stuff like that very easily. He's a Shiva devotee. And or with you and him suddenly together, suddenly things are happening very strongly. Other person's moon is coming on top of your ascendant, you might be easily going to Devi temples or things like that very easily. Because of the moon being that of Devi and all that, you know. It can be also Krishna also. You can say that also, that kind of thing. But yeah, usually for relationships, what I've seen, if the other person's planet, Venus is very important for relationship. So say Venus of the one person is on top of your ascendant, then that is 100% can be very good for relationship. So the marriage will be very good. And I've seen that no matter what is happening with the other planets, Venus is one planet that can give marriage. Same is the case in Jupiter. So with Jupiter, but there is a slight difference between Jupiter interacting in your chart, in your ascendant, versus Venus interacting. So Venus interacting, it's like you have a natural sense of diplomacy with your husband or wife. You're very good. You enjoy equal things. With that diplomatic kind of thing happens smoothly. Whereas when Jupiter is in on top of your ascendant, there might be more spiritual kind of thing happening more. So you might have to have, you might have a connection of a guru. Usually that's a frequent thing I've seen. Both of you are worshipping the same guru and that guru is responsible for your marriage. That is something I've seen. In some cases I've seen that, you know, Jupiter might also be, guru can also mean same spiritual practices also. You both also follow the same spiritual practices or have a common sense of spirituality. And that is that important in general. As simple as that, going towards temples can be as simple as being the same atheist organization. Can be anything as that, you know, because Jupiter can be both beliefs, you know, whatever beliefs you're holding on to. And Jupiter, what I've seen is that when Jupiter is on top of one person's ascendant, there is also very strong emphasis on education and spirituality in general. And then sometimes if the marriage is having problem, then you might have to seek someone else's advice. So some counselor is coming in, someone is to advise. Then it works very well. Because Jupiter is active and Jupiter is saving the seventh house of marriage through his aspect. You know, that is one thing. The other thing that can also work out very well if there are children involved. So in before marriage, husband and wife is fighting. A child comes in, then suddenly the child becomes like a guru. You know, and then child saves the marriage. Then husband and wife are together. But suddenly it's like it heals the marriage. You know, there's no more problem after that. That's something also I've seen. So Jupiter, we're talking about, so far we covered the benefits, Moon, Venus and Jupiter. So Mercury, now Mercury is coming on the ascendant. These are really good for playing pranks with each other or, you know, having this natural talk. You'll talk a lot very easily. Very, that smooth communication thing will happen when Mercury interacts with your ascendant. And of course, there'll be common senses and, you know, there'll be a small talk that is happening. You'll be constantly texting the other person. That kind of thing will happen, you know, very easily with Mercury interacting with the ascendant in general. And of course, Mercury is also short travels. It can also be studies, so attending workshops together, talking about your studies, all that kind of thing can happen. Or very good friendship can happen definitely. But you know, usually with relationships, look for Moon, Venus, and Jupiter. They're the first easiest thing to say that's good for marriage in general. In some cases, if it's extremely spiritual, you can do Sun. Now see, this doesn't mean that, you know, say your husband's or your wife's chart is already having planets, you can't convert that into marriage and stuff like that. If you understand the planetary influences, then you can improve your marriage. Because that person's, your ascendant is triggering that person's particular planets. If you understand what planet is being triggered, then you will see it happen, play out very intelligently and play it very naturally. If your ascendant is triggering that person's sun, then you might encourage, you yourself would be encouraging the other person to become very independent, to be who you are, be very unique, do whatever you want. That is very sun. You know, so you are ascendant triggering that person's solar qualities. You know, now if your ascendant is triggering that person's quality, that person may be too caring, too nurturing and things like that. And then of course you can encourage that. You will be naturally encouraging that also. That person will literally take care of you by default, you know. That's one thing that can be great also within a relationship. Same thing also, that person's relationship energies are being triggered also very easily. Jupiter can also trigger that. Same thing. But Jupiter might trigger it in a different fashion. Like, okay, how are we building our assets together? Or like any strategic kind of fashion, you know. How are we having the joint finances kind of thing together? And, you know, that kind of thing I've seen. Now, there are some interesting cases with the other planets. You know, usually with Mars on top of the ascendant, if you are ascending that person on Mars, they are great to have. You want to go fight with someone, you want a gunda with you, go fight with your enemies, great person to have you. You know, Mars kind of ascendant. Mars on top of your ascendant, you know. But then again, Mars can also be great in terms of facing very strong challenges together. That is something I've seen. So Mars on top of the ascendant, it might be usually Mars is a planet of the yogi. So there is a, so Kartikeya is the king of the, you know, the god of the yogis, the siddhas worship them and all that. Kartikeya, same in Hanuman also is yogi, you know, immortal yogi. Martian energy is very good for yoga kind of thing. So if you want a person, you ascend like a physical trainer, you'll find that either their Mars is interacting on your ascendant most commonly. Can be the, so literally training you like a soldier. The physical trainer, the personal trainer in your life is training you like a soldier to do the workout, to do the gym. Can be yoga teacher who's also making you teach the yoga, that kind of thing. So Mars is very disciplined in that way. But sometimes these people, because Mars, you might feel that you're being triggered. These people are making you angry for no reason. And you don't know why you're angry. But you'll find that when you do the synastry, it's your ascendant is interacting with Mars or that other person, you know. And then the next planet which you are talking about extensively was Saturn. So Saturn is, Saturn might enforce discipline more, and there might be a natural sense of pessimism which Saturn can bring. Of course, at the highest level of Saturn, Saturn can do service for you. So the person will be naturally triggering someone in your life, very naturally. And it's great for professional relationships of having a professional kind of distance and working things professionally to face difficult problems together. But in terms of a personal relation, sometimes Saturn can be harsh. That is just what it is. So Saturn can sometimes, if you're young, then sometimes immediately, these are the marriages that improve with the quality of time. So initially you marry, problems happen. Then as you become mature and you become older and your Saturn energies are integrated, then that's fine. So this was what I was saying, like when someone Saturn has met, then that marriage improves or that Saturn qualities has improved further, you know. So one person's, and you'll find that Saturn is bringing that real discipline. So it might be some hardship that Saturn can bring. So there is definitely a theme of hardship which you might have to face it. It might depend upon how capable or how mature your own personal Saturn is. That is what I've seen. So like say your Saturn is mature enough, then you know, a child Saturn falling on top of you, you'll feel nothing, you know. Say you are a child and someone else's Saturn is on top of you, then you'll feel that pressure. And usually those kind of things are the harsh teachers in your life. The teachers who strict you, are very strict with you, and then who ensure that you do, that kind of people are usually Saturn. And, you know, and then the biggest planetary connection, the more important connection is Rahu and Ketu. What I've seen with Rahu interacting with on the ascendant, there's a this link has been there for many lifetimes. Straightforward. So Rahu on top of it especially, but then there'll be an element of confusion with Rahu as always. You know, Rahu is definitely there'll be a confusion, and usually again it's like a quality of Saturn. Or sometimes you might understand this become mature and things like that only as you understand how Rahu works with you and all that. But then, one thing Rahu will give you is that Rahu functions subconsciously. So subconsciously, the person with the Rahu, he will kind of activate you in a subconscious kind of manner. He will just say one thing or the other, and then you'll see that he's pushing you towards your own life, you know, very, very subconscious manner. And but with Ketu interacting, what you might find is that he's giving you everything, but you feel this natural resistance. You are like, I don't want this guy's energy. I don't want this girl's energy with Ketu. You feel like something is there, but I don't want to. It's okay if there is a distance between me and him or me and her. This is a fine distance. Or sometimes you feel like, I don't know why I'm attracted to this guy or why I'm attracted to this girl. That can happen when Ketu's at. Because what is happening with Rahu and Ketu is that because this karma has been for multiple lifetimes, right? Many Ketu can sometimes be a very strong past life link. That is one thing I've seen. Now, this is especially with Ketu on top of the ascendant. Now, Ketu on top of the ascendant will also sometimes I've seen they can bring a lot of intuition to you, actually. A lot of spirituality is coming your way, and because of that. And also, it depends upon other persons to fair. And especially with Ketu and Rahu, you also have to look at what others are doing in the corresponding charts. The interaction of the Lords will give you much more stronger thing, you know. But usually, one thing that can happen is that I don't want this person immediately. I can, this is, he's great or she is great, but either time should happen and then we can happen. But sometimes the problem with Ketu is that I've seen, with Ketu, sometimes there might be a tendency towards long distance kind of relationship. Where Ketu is happening, the distance is fine. So Ketu is a flagpole. It's fine, see the other person from a distance and all that. But then when the actual thing is happening, when both you are in the same room, then suddenly, like, you know, it's not what you think it was. That kind of thing can be very strong with Ketu interaction with Ascendant. Now, but yeah, Babaji, I wanted to ask your opinion. What do you think about a planet, any particular planets that come to your mind when these planets are interacting with Ascendants in particular?
Yeah, one thing I can clearly say, that is, I have seen if the Ascendant Lords are friends, which means
right.
They are like Saturn, Venus, Mercury, Ascendant, both of you, or right. The other group, you know, Jupiter, right. Mars and Sun. Then I have seen there is a relative higher level of, I won't call it compatibility, but it's more of a natural understanding I have seen.
Right. Like,
for example, I have seen those who are from the Asura group, you know, which means Saturn, Mercury, right. Venus. And for right. Asuras, what it is, like Venus, that's primarily pleasure of sexuality and opposite sex, beauty and all this.
Right.
And external Mercury is all about money. The entire finances of this world is under Mercury. And then Saturn right. is the pain which comes, because suffering can come only from Mercury or Venus. No other planet can give you suffering.
Right.
All the right. questions related to astrology are pertaining to either Mercury or Venus. And what is astrology? I mean, astrology at a higher level is, you know, like, you know, it's Sun, it is Jupiter, it's Ketu, it's Mars. But people right. generally, 99% of them, and when I say this, people don't like. You know,
right.
they are coming to Jyotish, you know, for, you know, some big fancy stuff. No, it's all Mercury, Venus. Either your married life is spoiled, you are on the verge of divorce, or you hate the other person, or your finances are ruined. Let's be very clear, direct, no discussions, no
right.
game playing, direct Mercury. Right. So that is why Saturn right. is the, you know, the friend of these two. So whenever you have Mercury right. Venus, you will always have Saturn also with you. Always remember that, you know. So therefore, I have seen
right.
these ascendants in general. You know, so suppose I have seen somebody is, you know, maybe Taurus or somebody is Gemini, you know, and the other person is Capricorn or Aquarius. You know, if they sometimes keep talking, oh, you know, actually I have this, you know, I have a better career opportunity. Should I go? And the other person,
right.
yeah, yes, you can go. So the more you go higher, the more beatings you get, right? Because then more responsibility,
right.
the more the suffering it is. So
right.
this Mercury is pushing Saturn, you know, Saturn is also, you know, coming, embracing Mercury more and more. So the tears are more, because then to maintain
right.
the position, it becomes even more difficult. Now, this is not to discourage somebody from going high, but I'm just saying this is how it works, you know.
Right.
And the Sattvic right. ascendants I have seen, especially if it is with Cancer, I have seen. Or Jupiterian
right.
ascendants I have seen. They will be very good with, you know, for example, Leo or Cancer ascendants I have seen generally, because they will have a sense of purpose which is higher than Mercury Venus I have seen, which is higher than, you know, beyond sex and money. That is what I have seen.
Right.
Then sometimes right. if one friend says, you know, oh, I want to do this, you know, but my financially I may not be very well off, then if the other person is in that same category, you know, like Leo or Cancer, or for a Sagittarius the other way around, then they may encourage them, and, you know, they may say yes, you should do that more and not this, you know. Now this
right,
does not
right,
mean
right.
that that group people cannot be enemies, like, you know, Leo and
right.
Cancer can also be enemies. It doesn't mean that, and it also does
right.
not mean that Capricorn and you know, Sagittarius cannot be friends. It is not like that. But in general, I have seen, and yes, as usual, I always say, don't take these points which we are saying literally, because this can apply 0% for you and your partner.
Yep.
It can apply 1%, 10%, or 99%, or 100% even. So you may think, oh, what he is saying, you know, this is not correct, this is not right, it doesn't work with me, it doesn't work with him. No, you have to see the whole chart, and currently we are discussing only of the ascendant. So have patience and learn to see the whole chart, not the charts actually, because we are dealing with two charts now. So please don't think that if something which we both have shared now, if it doesn't work, then nothing is going to work for you. It's not like that. Okay, so just be patient and don't panic. You know, I've seen people panicking. Oh my God, you know, my Saturn is there. This has happened. It will not happen. Don't panic.
Yeah.
You will still live even after, even if you hear bad things about your combination in this video, you will still live. Yeah. Trust me, because your karmas are remaining. Okay.